with the release of the Apple 35W charger, more and more multi-port chargers are on the market. As we mentioned, some third-party chargers have a reconnection issue, but have you ever considered what would happen if we didn't remove the cable from multi-port charger? Today we will answer this question. We picked up 6 multi-port chargers, including power strips with USB ports and GaN chargers. We've also prepared the USB-A to USB-C, USB-A to Lightning, USB-C to Lightning, and dual USB-C cable. First, let's test this power strip, which has 2 USB-C ports and supports up to 65W charging. Use the dual USB-C cable to charge the MacBook and connect it to another USB-A to USB-C cable. Nothing happened. Replace with a USB-A to Lightning cable. Nothing happened. Add another USB-A to Lightning cable. Nothing happened. And replace with 2 USB-A to USB-C cables. Nothing happened. Then add another dual USB-C cable. Nothing happened. And finally, use the USB-C to Lightning cable to test. The tester will reboot and the charging power will drop to 44W. Next, let's do the second test. Use the USB-A to USB-C to charge an Android phone, and then add another USB-A to USB-C cable. Nothing happened. And replace with USB-A to Lightning cable. The tester will reboot again, and the power will gradually go back to normal. Let's switch to a 100W multi-port GaN charger for the third test, and firstly, charge it with dual USB-C cable. Then pay attention to what happens when we plug in different charging cables. Again, the tester will reboot and the power will drop to 44W after connecting to the USB-C to Lightning cable. The charger recognizes it as a charging device, even if the other side is not connected to anything. Next, let's start the fourth test. This is a 65W multi-port GaN charger. Use the dual USB-C cable to charge the MacBook. Firstly, add the USB-A to USB-C cable. Nothing happened. And then replace it with a USB-A to Lightning cable. Nothing happened. Next, let's do the fifth test. This 65W charger has 2 USB-C ports and a USB-A port. Use one of the USB-C ports to charge the MacBook and repeat our tests. After connecting to USB-C to Lightning cable, the tester also reboots and the power drops to 20W, which is also affected by the USB-C to Lightning cable. Finally, let's test with a 30W power strip with USB, and then add a USB-A to USB-C cable. Nothing happened. But after connecting to the USB-A to Lightning cable, the power will drop to 15W. Add another USB-A to Lightning cable. Same thing. Now you can understand that neither the USB-A to USB-C cable nor dual USB-C cable will affect the charging speed. But Apple USB-A to Lightning and USB-C to Lightning cables are different. Almost all multi-port chargers recognize the USB-C to Lightning cable as a charging device and affect other ports. Some chargers also recognize the USB-A to Lightning cable as a charging device because the built-in C94 and C48 chips still consume power even when not used. So please remember to remove Apple Lightning cable from the charger after charging your devices. And don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if you like this video. See you in the next video.